Hey, in today's video, I want to... Wait a minute. There's an update. Oh, let's download that. I'll see you in a minute. Hey, I downloaded the new version, Bitwig Studio 3.0 Beta 2, and there are a lot of new features in there, and you can see the features on the release notes here. And you can see we have now an output clipping parameter on the audio out of the grid device. As you can see here, we have now clipping off, hard and soft. Pretty nice. But today I want to talk about pulley rhythms and chords and how you can turn chords into pulley rhythms and back and why and so on. It's basically a small trick how you can create rhythms. So I have the grid already open and we have already a small setup here, an envelope module that goes to the audio out. And at first we need an oscillator and I choose an saw oscillator. As you can see in the tab here, oscillator, saw, and then you select this module, drag it in. And then we need a mixer. And then we drag the oscillator into the mixer and the mixer goes into the envelope module. And we need, of course, multiple oscillators. So we duplicate this. And we need to attach this to the mixer too. And now we have three oscillators playing pretty loud. Okay, and now we turn these oscillators into a chord. So we have our bass root note here, which is zero. Then we choose the major third, which is four semitones up. And then we use the perfect fifth to tune it to seven semitones up. So this should be a major chord. Okay, and now we want to turn everything down in pitch. But for that, we use a value parameter here. And now we use an IO output, modulator out, to actually modulate the pitch information here. Then I attach the value to this modulator out and I modulate the pitch offset here, drag it down, so done. Then we change the ratio on the oscillators to go low enough. Okay, so just drag this up to 5. So this should already sound pretty deep. So it's just pitch down basically. But we want to go deeper, so we can turn up this value here. And you can hear a rhythm, a polyrhythm. So there are three rhythms playing together, okay? And to better distinguish the sounds, we implement a filter device in between each of these oscillators. And I'm gonna use this one here, this. So maybe this is the bass drum, this is the snare, and this is the hi-hat. So let's see how it sounds. So we can even go lower, so the rhythm is slower. Or we can change the chord to a minor chord. Now we want to use these low-pitched LFOs or oscillators to actually use it as an timing signal to trigger another oscillator in a more audible range, okay? So As you can see here, we have our first saw, and when we use the oscilloscope, every time a phase is done, we have a parameter jump from 0 to 1, and we actually can use this to trigger gates. In this case, we use this gate here. You have to turn this off. So you can hear, we trigger basically every time a phase is done, we trigger this envelope. And we can use this to route a different oscillator in here, which has a different voicing. Or let's use multiple ones. And again, let's use a mixer device here. And now we route everything. There. So the first oscillators generate a signal, a timing signal, in an unusual way, which basically is a chord pitched down, and we use these timing signals to trigger another oscillators in a different pitch range to actually have more a more musical approach to the sound, so we can shape the sound more, and these oscillators are basically just only for the timing. And you can advance this technique more and more and completely get rid of the timing of Bitwig itself and only use the oscillators in. Go in different rhythm structures. Use different ratios. Even can play on the keyboard if you turn this knob here on. You can basically change the pitch with the keyboard. Okay, let's clean this patch a bit up. We delete this mixer, yeah, because we don't use the output as an audio signal. We just use it as a timing signal, so we can delete that. We don't really need the filters because we also just need it as a timing signal, so we can remove that. Oh, you can hear it has a small effect on the sound and on the triggering, so you can decide if you want to leave that in. But I think instead of the saw oscillator, it's better to use a triangle. So let's replace that. And turn it this way. There's no triggering. Why? I think there's a bug. Okay, it was not in the audible range. Okay. much better. So I think the triangle is better because the one signal is always at the start of the phase. So it's better for timing, I think. Okay, let's try some better pitches for the sounds. So zero. So much better. Yeah, and you can develop this further, make better sounds, make more timings, different timing signals. And it's pretty fun and it's pretty easy to set up. And you can see how easy it is to create rhythm structures with oscillators. So you have oscillators for the timing and the sound. And for modulations, you can use oscillators for everything. It's pretty nice. Yeah, that's basically it for this video, for this episode. Thanks for watching. If you have suggestions or if you have questions or critique, please leave it in the comments. Leave me a thumbs up if you like the video, thumbs down if you don't like it. And I see you in the next video, I hope, tomorrow. Bye.